If you would like to increase the conversion rates on your landing pages, then you need to A/B split test your pages. Keep watching and I'll show you how. Hello, I'm Uzair and thanks for joining in. In this video, I'm going to talk about A/B split testing your landing pages. So why would you want to A/B split test your pages? Because if you don't A/B split test your landing pages, you would never know whether you are leaving any cash on the table for your competitors to take away. So you got a great landing page and you're happy with it, but if you're not testing it against another version of that page, then you would never know what may happen and how you can improve that conversion rate. So before I go and show you designs of a landing page, let me go through a couple of things as to how you can get started with testing your landing pages. So I've got my notepad here. So first of all, you would need some kind of software where you can drive traffic to your landing pages and split the landing pages into two. So you need to create two versions, let's say version one or version two, or version A or version B, whichever way you want to call it. The most popular software are Google Optimize, which is completely free, and these other three, which are Unbounce, ClickFunnels, and Lead Pages, are paid ones. We use Unbounce in our business. I've been using it for the last 3 years or so. Really like it, and it is very, very simple and easy to use. The support is excellent and we're very happy with it. So there's no need to change to some other software. So Unbounce is our preferred software. So use any one of these to design your pages. Or if you have got a web design background, then you can create web pages in HTML and then use Google Optimize to drive traffic to those pages. So the way A/B split testing works is you are running the test simultaneously on the two pages. So you need to split the traffic. So half the traffic goes to page A and half the traffic goes to page B. Now we can split at 50-50, 60-40, or however you want. I prefer to split them 50-50, so half the traffic goes to one page, half to the other one, so I can get the data evenly across both the pages and see what's happening. So what do you need to split test with? What do you want to change? The things which you can split test is change the headline or the call to action on the buttons, use different images or a different video, have a green button on one and a blue one or an orange one on the other one, change the content a little bit, or perhaps split test the forms, have a short form on one and a longer one on the other one. What you don't want to be doing is to change all of these on both the pages. Just test with one headline first. So the rest of the items on both the pages are the same, only the headline is different or the call to action is different and so on. So just make one. Because if you are changing, or if you have created a web page, pages which are completely different, then it's not a true A/B split test. It is called a multivariant testing, where you've got completely two different pages. So for the A/B test, all you need to do is to just change one thing at a time for the test when you're running, and then you drive traffic for a certain amount of time or impressions or clicks and see what happens. So let me show you one of my A/B split tests. So what I tend to do is to keep on top of the data, I create a Google Doc and then screenshot design one and design two. So all you can, as you can see in here, the difference is the video. So I'm split testing a different video with a different image, or what we call the custom image on the video, to see which one is getting the most conversions. So when I start a split test, I put in the date, and then one version is called the champion and the other one is the challenger. So if I've been running these tests for long and this has been the winner, then I'm going to create another one with a new video or a different headline or whatever, and then call this version as the challenger. So this is going to challenge the champion, which is the winning one. So this is how you keep on improving your conversion rate. Then I'll run it for a few weeks, or for amount of money or impressions, however you want to do it. And then I'm going, when I pause the A/B test, then I'm going to put in the impressions, clicks, conversions, and the conversion rates over here, and then the same for the challenger. So then I can see what's happening. And then when I start the next A/B split test, I'm just going to make another page, then screenshot both the pages and the data which has been accumulated, and I'll just keep on going on this document, so I can see the historic data of the split test, because it's quite easy to lose all these data if you keep on changing, which you should be challenging the champion version from time to time, and making so that you can improve the conversion rates on your landing page. To recap, start A/B split testing your landing pages and see how it helps you improve your conversion rates. That's it for now. I do appreciate your time with me, and I look forward to seeing you in the next videos. Bye for now.